Good morning all. Myself Dr. Ansar Ahmed, and as you know, we are having lectures on conventional circuits. What are conventional circuits? Those circuits in which output depends only on the present inputs, not previous output, not previous inputs. They have no memory. So in that category, the conventional circuit divided into three sections, arithmetic and logic functions, second data transmission, and third code converter. So first arithmetic and logic functions we have covered up, in which we discuss about half adder, full adder, half subtractor, full subtractor, and comparator. And today we are going to take another category of classification of conventional circuit, that is data transmission. Data transmission, that is those circuits, those conventional circuit which help out to transmit data or receive the data. Okay, so first is the multiplexer. And what is multiplexer? And what is multiplexer, and why this is so important? A multiplexer is a digital switch that has multiple inputs and a single output. So is the speciality of MUX is it has n inputs, okay, and it has n inputs and one outputs only. So this is economical, because in place of many channels, we can use only one channel out of which can transmit one inputs out of many inputs. Okay, so this is very useful conventional circuits, and easy to use because it is available in the IC, and there is no need of any wire and to make the circuit complex or costly. Okay, the select line determine which input is connected to the output. Okay, so it has n inputs, one outputs, and inputs are selected, which input is going to the output, which is this is selected with the help of select line. Okay, and this is the symbol of MUX. Now this is the simple definition. Now with the help of this example, you might understand what is a MUX. So a MUX, this is a MUX, and there are four inputs are connected, like MP3 player, laptop, then digital satellites and digital cable TV. So these are all connected with this MUX, and this is single outputs. Okay, so out of four, one output, one be the part of output, and how they will be selected? They will be selected with the help of select line A and B, the value of A and B. So when the value of A B will be equal to 0 0, then MP3 will be selected. Then when the value of A B will be 0 1, then laptop will be selected. When the value of 1 0 will be selected, that is satellite will be selected, and lastly cable TV. So this is the way. And how this is important, because in place of using four channels, we are using single channels for four inputs. Okay, so at a time one can be sent, like this time one time MP3, then next time laptop, and then digital, then cable TV, as per the selections line. Okay, so features of multiplexer, it has that data inputs. Fine, these are the data inputs, where n is the control inputs, one outputs, a multiplexer routes the selected data input to the outputs, as we have explained. The particular input selected for output is determined by the value of the multiplexer control line. So which inputs will be selected? It is selected by control lines or selection line. The number of controls line can be calculated by this one, that is n is equal to, that is m is equal to log base to n, where n is the number of inputs of multiplexer. How many type of multiplexer we can have? We can have 2 is to 1 multiplexer, 4 is to 1 multiplexer, 8 is to 1 multiplexer, and 16 is to 1 plexer, in which they have the particular select line. In this one, we are having only one select line, and this is having 4 is to 2 select line, and we can find out this one with the help of 2 to the power n. Okay, so this is the select line. M is the select line. So m is equal to number of inputs. If m is equal to 4, then 2 to the power n, and then this is we can write 2 to the power 2 as it. Okay, then this is 2 to the power n, and if we compare, then it will be n is equal to 2. Okay, n is equal to 2. Yes, then similarly we can find out simply just take the power of inputs, and you will find the number of selections line, like 8 is to 1, 2 to the power 3, 16, 2 to the power 4, then 4 selects line. Now example of 2 is to 1 mux. A mux is written like this one, 2 is to 1 mux. 2 is to 1 mux will have two inputs, 0, I0, I1, that is 0, 0 and 0, 1, and one select line. Okay, and this is 4 is to 1 mux. It will have four inputs, I0, I1, I2, I3, and this is two selection lines, S0, S1. Now let's design a 4 is to 1 mux. Of course, we are not going to forget all six rules to design the conventional circuit. First is, do you remember? First is problem definition. So design a 4 is to 1 mux. Okay, this is the first step. Then we need to find out the inputs and outputs required. So it will have four inputs, I0 to I3, and one output. The next we need to give the symbol letters to those inputs and outputs. So we are naming as I0, I1, I2, I3, and I4. So this is the step one. So this is the step third. Okay. Fine. And then fourth is truth table. Okay, truth table. So this is the because we are having two selection line, then possible combination of selection line will be 2 to the power 2 is equal to 4. So 4 possible combination of S0, S1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. Okay, then what will be the fifth step, that is Boolean expression, simplified Boolean expression. So how we are going to write output, which output will be considered out of 4? This is this one, I is equal to S1, that is 0, we can write as S1 bar. Okay, S0 bar. Okay, then we can write as S1 bar. Okay, then S0. Okay, so we can write here this one, S0 bar, S1 bar, S0, right? Then S1, S1 bar, S0, I1. Then this is S1, S0 bar, I2. This is this one. And this is S1, S0, I3. So this is the simplified. Okay. Now, last step is to design the logic 1 max. 4 is to 1 mux logic diagram. Okay, why this is happening? Because you can't believe I'm recording these lectures third times, because in the previous two lectures I had some problem, in one I had some disturbances, and other one when I got it complete lectures of 47 minutes. Then when I replay it, then there was no voice. Actually, I just forgot to on the mic. So it was very horrible. That's why I'm feeling some irritating this time. But don't worry, I will deliver in my best way. So these are the logic circuit diagram, I0, I1, I2, I3. Then just implement this equation here. So with the help of this, with the help of this S0, S1 and I0, I1, like if I want to apply this S0, S1, I0, okay. So where is this one? Where is this one? S0, okay. S0, I0, so here aapka this one I0, then S0 is this one, and S1 bar is this one. Similarly, we can design the entire Boolean expression. Now the next is design 8:1 multiplexer. So in number of inputs, 8, I0 to I7, okay. And what will be the number of selections line? Just simply 2 to the power 3, because it will be equal to 8 inputs. So this will be the number of selections line. So there are selection line A, B, C. Guys, please don't forget which one is the MSB and which is the LSB, because it can create some problems to your answers. Okay, so MSB, and this is the LSB. Then how many number of combinations of selection line will be possible? 8, 2 to the power 3, then 0 to 7. These are the possible combination of selection line ABC. Then symbol, as we have written the Boolean expression in the previous example, you can write here A bar, because this is 0, then B bar, because B is equal to 0, then C is equal to 0, to C bar and I0. So this is the, this is equivalent to this one. Ab suppose kariye, this is, I want to write it last minute likh raha hu main, just A B, because these values are 1 1, then I7. So this is this equation. Similarly, you can write all, like if you want to write this one A, you have to write starting from 0 to 7, okay. And this is the logic circuit diagram, okay. Logic diagram, okay. This is driven from this Boolean expression, okay. So these all having AND gates, which are finally ORing. Now there are some questions which I would like to explain for the exam point of view. Construct 8:1 mux using 2 4:1 mux and 1:2:1 mux, okay. So we need to design it 8:1 mux, but the restriction is here. We are not going to design with the help of 8:1 directly. In place of it, we are using 2 4:1 mux and 1 2:1 mux also. So because we have to design 8:1 mux, so there will be 8 inputs, okay, and 8 inputs, no doubt. So what will be the number of selections line? That is 2 to the power 3, that is 3 in selection line, S0, S1 and S2, and these are the output, these are the inputs, I0 to I7, because this is 8:1 mux. And finally, we will write the Boolean expression. Boolean expression, that is, ek main aapko example ke taur pe likhe bata deta hu, S2, because S2 is 0, so it will be S2 bar, S1 bar, okay, then S0 bar. दिस इज एस टू बार, देन ये मैं सिर्फ आपको एग्जाम्पल के तौर पे लिख के बता रहा हूँ, एस वन, सो इट विल बी एस वन एस ज़ीरो बार, सो दिस विल बी दिस वन. सो सिमिलरली यू कैन राइट ऑल इक्वेशंस, फाइन. देन द देन यू हैव टू डिज़ाइन थेट मार्क्स विद हेल्प ऑफ 4:1 मार्क्स, बिकॉज वी हैव टू कंस्ट्रक्ट 8:1 मार्क्स, सो वी नीड टू टू 4:1 मार्क्स. वन इज दिस वन, ओके. वाई दिस इज वन, बिकॉज इट विल हैंडल फोर इनपुट्स, i0 to i7, बिकॉज ए मार्क्स कैन हैंडल ओनली फोर इनपुट्स एंड वन आउटपुट्स. सो दिस इज वन मार्क्स एंड दिस इज अदर फोर इनपुट्स विल बी हैंडल बाई दिस अदर मार्क्स, दिस इज मार्क्स नंबर टू. ओके, सो दिस इज i4 to i7. ओके गाइज, एंड दीज आर द सिलेक्शंस लाइन s0 and s1. ओके, नाउ वी कैन राइट i0 एज 0 0, दैट इज 0 1, देन 1 0, देन 1 1. ओके, देन वी कैन राइट हेयर i4 i0 0, देन i5 i0 1, एंड देन i0 1 1, दिस इज 6 एंड दिस इज 1 1. ओके, सो हाउ यू विल सेलेक्ट द आउटपुट इनपुट्स विद द हेल्प ऑफ सिलेक्शंस लाइन. द आउटपुट ऑफ दिस टू मल्टीप्लेक्सर विल बी द इनपुट्स फॉर द 2:1 मार्क्स. सो लेट्स सी, आई एम कमिंग बैक ऑन दिस वन. व्हेन वी विल अप्लाई s0 s1, देन ऑब्वियसली इन एनी इनपुट्स ऑफ मल्टीप्लेक्सर 1 एंड मल्टीप्लेक्सर 2 विल बी सिलेक्टेड. ओके, देन व्हाट्स अबाउट s2 विल बी हेयर s2, दैट इज when the value of s2 will be 0, then what will be the inputs selected? Mux 1 inputs will be selected. Okay, when the value of s2 will be 1, then these i4 to i7, ye aapka iske sath hai, then mux 2 inputs will be selected. Okay, now let's get this with the help of some example. Suppose I am taking this value, this is s is equal to s0 and s1 is equal to 1 1. Okay, and s2 is equal to 0. So hamare pas what is the value for, that is s2 कितना है आपका, s1 and s0, सो दिस इज फॉर 0 1 1. सो व्हेन द वैल्यू ऑफ s0 1 and s1 is also 1, सो विच इनपुट्स विल बी सिलेक्टेड, लेट्स सी. 1 1, दिस इज i3, हेयर i3, सो इट विल बी सिलेक्टेड. Okay, but you can see here when, because the same inputs line also applying here, that is 1 1 is also here, so it can be selected with the help of these selections line. So one output you will get here, okay, this one, that is i7. So you are having i7 and i3 because based on the 2 bits. Okay, then what is the value of s2? Then the value of s2 is 0. So in the previous slides we have seen that when the value of s2 will be 0, then for these all inputs we will get the outputs. Okay, so when the value of s2 will be 0, then this value i3 will be selected. Okay. Now we can take the other example also. Suppose this is the value which I am taking. 110 110. So again this is 110. So s0 आपका s0 आपका 0 है, s0 आपका 0 है और s1 आपका 1 है. देन विच इनपुट्स विल बी सिलेक्टेड. 10 देखिए आपका कहाँ है, 10 आपका यहाँ भी है और 10 आपका यहाँ भी है. ओके सो हेयर i2 विल बी सिलेक्टेड एंड हेयर i6 विल बी सिलेक्टेड. सो दीज विल बी द इनपुट्स ऑफ this multiplexer. Now what is the value of S2? The value of S2 this time is 1. So which multiplexer output will be reflect here? Of course this one. Okay, so this is the verification of the working of your 8:1 mux. Now design a 16:1 mux using 4:1 mux. Similarly we can design 16:1 mux as we have done here. तो आप क्या करेंगे इसके लिए, just giving a easy idea, that is required input 16. These are the required inputs and these are the available inputs 4. That is you need to design with the help of 4:1 mux. So this will be n by n1 upon n2, that is 16 by 4, this is 4. Again the remainder will be divided by 4 again, then it will be 1. So total number of mux, 4:1 mux, total number of mux jo hoga, it will be 4 plus 1, that is 4 and 1 here. So total number of mux required, sorry, that is 5 mux required. Okay, so these are required. Now rest is simple. Because we are designing 16:1 mux, so we need 16 inputs. Okay, so these are the 16 inputs which will start from 0 to 1. I am saying here output because out of 16, one output will be available. And what will be the selections line? That is 2 to the power 4. 4 selections line A, B, A, C and D. Okay. Then now next is abhi hame 4:1 mux se design karna. So how many mux we need? 5. So this is like these are like this one. 4 inputs will be 4 inputs 4 inputs and then 4 inputs. Okay, so we are having total 16 inputs and these are 4 outputs of first stage which will be the inputs for the next or the last mux. Okay, so this will be 4 inputs. And how they will be selected? They will be selected with the help of these A, B, C, D. So 2, C and D, because 4:1 mux can have only 2 selections line. So S0, S1, which is renamed as CD. Okay, CD will be applied here and rest 2 selections line will be select final inputs. Okay, which will get the final output. Okay, this is same as we have done in the previous example, so don't worry about anything. And this is the final answer, 16:1 mux using 4:1 mux. Now in the exam there may be many type of questions, in many ways question may be asked. So this is the implement function using mux. So this is the f given function, this is the min terms 0, 2, 3, 4, 6 and we have to design it with the mux. it is not saying with this is we have to design with the help of 2 is to 1, 4 is to 1 or 8 is to 1. So just check how many number of variables, 3. So number of possible inputs will be 8. Okay, so this will be the 8 inputs. Okay, so this is 8 is to 1 marks starting from I0 to I7. Okay, this will be one output. How many number of selections line? Of course, 3. 3 A and B and C. So what you else do? Just whatever number of minterms you are having here, connect these minterms with the logic 1. Okay, so this is logic 0 and logic 1. Logic 0 and logic 1. तो जो यहाँ पे प्रेजेंट है यू कैन कनेक्ट दिस ऑल मीन टर्म्स विद द लॉजिक वन लाइक 0, 2, 2 एंड देन 3 देन 4 देन 6 दीज आर प्रेजेंट एज द मीन टर्म्स सो मेक दीज ऑल मीन टर्म्स हाई दैट इज कनेक्ट विद दिस लॉजिक वन एंड रेस्ट कनेक्ट विद द लॉजिक 0 लाइक I1 देन I5 एंड I7 ओके सो दिस इज the final answer. It is simple. Then there is no bar, this no condition. But if this question may ask in this way, this is the same questions which may be asked like this way, then what will happen? Implement function using 4 is to 1 marks. Okay, this is the same question which we have done it. Now the condition we have to use 4 is to 1 marks. So what will we design? 4 is to 1 marks have 4 inputs and 4 inputs and 1 outputs. And what will be the number of control lines or selection line? Of course, 2. A and B. So what will we do about, because it should be designed, it is a 8 is to 1 marks. So what we have to do? What's about third selections line? So that will be design by A techniques. Now you have to write all inputs I0, I1, I2, I3. ठीक है and just you can write it A bar, B bar, A bar, B as per these digits. And in the vertical you can write C bar and C. That is C bar for 0 and C is equal to 1. Now just as per these 0 and 1, that is 0 0, the cell number will be 0. Okay, then these are the MSB and this is the LSB. So 0 0 1, this is 1, then this is 2. You can just check the digit and find out the cell number. Of course, this is not like K-map because in K-map we use the gray code, but here you can see we are not having gray code. These are the consecutive 0001 1011. These are all inputs, so there is a little bit difference. Now what you have to do next, then these present minterms, these are small m, these minterms please fill one in place of that minterm like 0 1. Then 2, फिर 1 कहाँ पे आएगा आपका 3 पे आएगा, then 4 and then 7. Okay, so replace all cells with the one where we are having the minterms. Okay, then just have a technique. This is 1, so this is only one single one, so where we are locating the one, this is equivalent to C bar. Okay, but when we are having two ones, that is in the cell C0, C bar and C1, C bar and C, then it can be written as 1, that is C plus C bar is equal to 1. This is the Boolean laws. Okay, so C bar plus C is equal to 1. Then this is in the column of C bar. Then again this is in the column of C bar. So write it. Now just see this C bar is in the column of I0. 1 is the column of I1, then C bar is in the column of I2. Then connect these all selections like third selection line with this directly with these inputs. So this is C bar 1, C bar and this C bar, and you get the final answer. So is it, this is easiest. This is nothing to understand. Now let's get a very important question. It might be asked in the examination. Implement full adder using 4:1 mux. A full adder is a combinational circuit which add 3 bits to 2 bits and 1 carry input. Okay, and it has sum and carry out as the outputs. So we have to design number of inputs. Kitna hai hamara number of inputs? 0 to 7. Okay. So this is the table. This is the truth table, and these are the selection line X, Y, and C input, and these are the output. Because our mux have only one output, so we need 2 mux to design this full adder, one for the sum, another for the carry out. So first of all, we will just check out the mux for the sum. Just write down the sum in terms of min terms. So these are the min terms of sum. 1, 2, 4, 7. We know already. I suppose I'm not going to discuss it. Okay. Then we need to use 4:1 mux, which will have 2 inputs and 4 2 selections line and 4 inputs and 1 outputs. Then we need to design third selections line. Okay, third selection line, and we will apply the same formula, that is 0001 1011, then 01. Okay, this is just like KMAP, but not actually KMAP, because KMAP use array code. So this is again 0 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. You can just find out 00 yahan se nikal sakte hain. So just fill up these midterms in the cell. 1, this is 1, this is 2, and this is 3, 4, this is 5, this is 6, this is 7. Now you have to write the final selections line instructions, that is 1 is present in Cin1 only. So right here Cin, this one is present in the column of Cn bar. And this one is also Cn bar, and this is again Cn bar, and this is just connected to the inputs. So Cn bar is connected with the I0, Cn bar I1, Cn bar again I2, and Cn I3. So this is the final mux using 4:1. Okay, so you can design in such a way. I think this is very easy. Today I wasted a lot of time because of my mistake, or because of the technical mistakes. I repeated this lecture thrice, and but I hope you understand it in better way. Guys, if you are not getting it, please let me know. And if you want to give any suggestion or any idea to make it better, please let me know. And very important thing, that is these all lectures are connected, available on the YouTube. Please subscribe my lectures, like it, share it, and subscribe, because the latest lecture will reach to you by that intimation. And very important thing, please take care and have a great time.